In KK Java tutorials, in this video of data structure and algorithm, we will write a program to find length of a singly linked list in Java. Yeah, so here you can see in various videos I have written this code, right? So here basically we have a linked list, a generic linked list, and here I have declared a head, right? Because in linked list, first node always points to the head. Yeah. Now we have an internal class which basically represents node in linked list. Node is having a two part, first the data and second the reference which is pointed to the next node. Yeah, so here we have a data part and next reference, and we have a constructor there. I have initialized data as well as next pointer. Next pointer initially pointed to the null, right? Now here I have a method is called insert, which basically help me to insert various nodes in the linked list. This is pretty simple. I had written from scratch in one of the video, and I had explained, so I hope you would have watched my previous video tutorial. Now this is the one of the method which basically help us to display the entire linked list, right? Now here I have created an object of linked list and just inserting few nodes, right? And I'm printing this linked list, and just I'm calling the size method, which is right now incomplete. So we have to complete so that this will return us the size of linked list, right? So it's very simple. So first of all, we have a base case. So here what we have to do, we have to take one length variable in slice with zero, and first of all you have to check the base condition. If head is null, that means entire linked list is empty, right? In that case, we have to return that length itself, which is already initialized with zero. Else, we have to traverse from head to end of the list. And remember one thing, last node always pointing to the null. That's the basically condition for termination for any loop, right? So we have to loop through the every node, and we need to increment length counter every time by one, right? And finally, that length count we have to return. Pretty simple, right? So here I am going to write the code. So first of all, what I have to do here, first of all you need to do if base condition, you have to write if head equals to null, right? So what is nothing but the instance variable in this class null. That means list is empty. Before that, what we have to do, we have to do in int length in a slide with zero, right? This is kind of counter. Now head is null, that means we have to return the length itself, right? Length, right? Zero will be returned. Else there would be a second case, linked list would not be null, right? Linked list has some nodes, right? Then in that case, what I'll do, I'll create a node, and here I'll give the name as current a node. So we have to assign the head, right? Head. So we have to start traversing from the head, right? And here of course we required one while loop. Yeah, and there I have to check current node not equal to null, sorry, not equal to null. Then we have to go inside, and length variable we have to increment by one. So I'll write length plus plus, right? And of course we have to write current node equal to current node dot next, right? Why current dot next? Because initially current node is pointing to the head. When you do current node dot next, that will go to here in first iteration, then second iteration, third iteration, and every iteration just we are incrementing this length variable, and finally we have to return this length here. Yeah? Cool. So simple. Now here you can see I have a list which is having 5 elements, right? And just I'm printing entire list, right? So if I run this application, then you'll see here I have printed the list. So here last node of the list is 25, which is pointing to the null. So last node in the list always pointing to the null reference, right? And here you can see there are 5 elements in the list, and this is printing size as 5. If you create let's say a new link list, let's say I'm going to create a new link list here and give a name as 2, right? And if you try to calculate length for this guy, then this should print 0 because there is no node added. We haven't added any node in this list, right? So this should print 0, right? If I run, and here you can see it is printing 0. So base condition is also working perfectly fine. So guys, this is pretty simple, and this is very important interview question as well. So that's all I wanted to discuss in this video tutorial, guys. Guys, big thank you for watching this video, and see you there in the next video tutorial.